friends. I just thought I'd do a quick video about this Gotek. This is a brand new Gotek from the Gotek factory, and I sell them on eBay. There's a link in the description if you're interested. This particular Gotek is malfunctioning, out-of-box failure, we used to call it. And I'll insert a clip right now as to what it's doing. It seems to be thinking that you're always wanting to upgrade it. I think that basically means that the button is stuck down or shorted or something. It could be either both of these buttons together, or more likely it's this one, because all you need to do is press this, hold this one down, and it will initiate an upgrade, although it won't complete unless you release the button. So it'll just stay on that screen until you let go, and if it's shorted, it's going to act like it's going to be locked up. So this happens probably one out of every 50, I guess, of these Goteks that I receive from the factory. Actually, you know what the most common fault is? This knob on here is pushed all the way down until it's making contact with the plastic, therefore not allowing you to be able to push the button to select. So this is the reason why we test them fully before we send them out, before we put them on our shelf as our stock, really, is when it happens. So yeah, I don't know if all sellers do that. If they don't, then they're going to get some customers, buyers that are not happy. Let's see if we can get this. Well, I guess I'll just take the whole thing out. A little bit of a trick to get this out of here. Just have to. There we go. And this is usually where I find the problem. I can test it with a multimeter real quick, but it could actually be that the actual rotary encoder is bad. Let me take a deeper dive into this and let you know what I find. Okay. Yeah, I think it's these two pins. Can't really see what I'm doing, can you? These two pins right here. See, I have 26 ohms right now, but if I press it down, hold on, it's hard to hold it on there. If I push it, I get full continuity. So there's a partial short. It's a partial short, very low ohmage. You know, 18 ohms or whatever. And when I push the button, it does a dead short. So something is partially shorting it. It might actually be the rotary encoder itself, because I can't think of what else. Let's just see which pins here we have. Okay, so these two pins. What is it? This one and this one? What it is? Yeah. So these two come down to these two, that one and that one, and subsequently these two. So I should get my 26 ohms or whatever. 27, yeah. It's not coming out easy. Probably grab a flathead screwdriver, but I don't know if you guys can see what I'm doing. I'm just trying to get the stupid jumpers out of here. It's taking a lot of force, and what I'm looking for is some kind of partial short here. Okay, now with it disconnected, we're going to see if we have a partial short. There shouldn't be any, I don't think there should be any continuity put it on just straight ohms here and measure the resistance between these two. 58 ohms. I don't think that's right. I think it's supposed to be open. See, now we're at 64 ohms. You know what? Let me try this. Pretty tough to. There, this should work. Okay, let's see if we can get this. It's shorted. It's back down to 27. So I think it's the encoder, and I might have to replace it. All right, so let me unhook this part. And really, all I have to do is unhook one of them because. Plug. Yeah, 20 ohms now on the diode test. That's not actually how many ohms it is. I'll switch it to ohms and it's 300 ohms, and it's unplugged, so it absolutely shouldn't be doing that. Okay, so we're definitely on an almost dead short, and there really isn't anywhere else it could be besides in this actual rotary encoder. So I need to come up with a solution there. Let me see what parts I have. Try to figure something out. You know what, guys? I'm going to, since I place orders for Gotek all the time, I don't see why I should waste my time trying to reinvent the wheel when I can just have them send me an extra one of these. So at least that way this will be completely original again. And not, you know, what some might call hacked up or whatever. So that's what I'm going to do. Anyway, I wanted to give you an example of how some of these can arrive, you know, with an out-of-box failure. Let's put it that way. Damaged in shipment or somehow whatever. But anyway, so anyway, I just wanted you to see the lengths that I take before I sell things on eBay by testing things to make sure they work. And it works pretty well because I get almost no returns. You know, once a year or something crazy like that. Anyway, that's all for this video. Thanks for watching, friends, and we'll see you next time.